Hello everyone, welcome you all. Today we are going to discuss about the topic Judas, written by Mervyn Morris. About the author, Mervyn Eustace Morris is a poet and professor emeritus at the University of the West Indies, Mona, Jamaica. He is one of the first academics to expose us the importance of national language and helping to define in verse important aspects of Jamaican culture. Morris has published several volumes of poetry and has edited the works of other Caribbean writers. About the poem, it is a controversial poem and deconstructs the story of biblical Judas. Judas is a speaker. It presents the betrayal of Jesus in a new light. It can be read in a post-colonial perspective. Biblical Judas Iscariot, one of the original 12 apostles of Jesus Christ, he is a controversial character. He betrayed Jesus by kissing him and calling him Rabbi. Judas brought men to arrest Jesus and identified him with a kiss. He got price of 30 pieces of silver, later regretted and returned the money to priests. At last he committed suicide for his deed. Criticize of God's creation. The poem criticizes God's creation of disloyal people like Judas. The speaker is Judas. He says that he didn't betray Jesus for 30 bits of silver. It was nothing for him. Didn't the master know that Judas was going to betray? Judas asked this question. According to Judas, he served the master sincerely. Summary of the poem. This poem was written by Mervyn Eustace Morris, a Jamaican poet. Morris usually stresses upon the importance of nation and its language through his verse. He wants to redefine the aspect of Jamaican culture and the Creole language. In the first stanza, it had told that the master gave Judas a mocking smile, but actually Christ simply smiled at Judas. But in these lines, Morris has exaggerated the smile into a mocking smile. The word mocking seemed to be the striking word, and therefore poet wanted to highlight the mocking glance of the master. Continuation of the summary. The poet explains the Judas' feelings of being partial by his master, who had given the priority for John to sit in his right. This was again the poet's partial feeling even in his own homeland by the colonizers. He has said that the truth which is in the side of colonized is always complicated in the foreign eyes. Also, the colonizers is the knowing judge of man. In the sense, whatever they say is believed by the world. Victim's view. And the old poem, Judas by Mervyn Morris, is nothing but a representation of history by the point of view of the victim. He has deconstructed the real and the past, that is, deconstructing the already existing ideas. Also, he wanted to say that the colonized people ideas and life thoughts are not accepted, whereas the colonizers ideology, life and thoughts were accepted. The poet uses the word master and lord for Christ in order to avoid the religious conflict. Conclusion. Though he describes the pathetic condition of colonized people in the poem, the comparison used in this poem is quite controversial. However, the poet tried to escape of controversies through his careful selection of words and diction. Thank you for watching.